Here's another node I love to use. Let's jump into Houdini and check it out.
Pin to target. I use this node all the time as it has so many use cases. Let's take a look at some of them. The permanent mode fixes points to the position you specify. It doesn't allow the constraint to grow or shrink, but it keeps it fixed rigidly. You can also have the pin group animated, which is useful. The soft constraint allows you to change how rigid you want your constraint to be. You can have it be permanently pinned, or you can adjust it so that it is more influenced by Vellum. The stopped constraint allows you to release these constraints inside DOPs with attributes. Let's take a look at some of these setups. Let's take a look at how to set up a soft constraint. We're going to start with a sphere, and we need to change this to polygon. We'll reduce the scale to something like 0.5 and turn up the frequency to 10. We're then going to use a mountaintop to give our spheres some shape. We'll also use this mountaintop to give our sphere animated noise so that we can showcase how the soft constraint works. For now, let's animate the height property from 0 to 2 over 15 frames. We can also reduce the element scale to something like 0.3. Let's use a small expression to constantly offset our noise. We'll use something like $frame, which is taking our frame number, and we're going to multiply it by 0.01 to slow it down. Now we have a constantly moving noise through our sphere. Let's use a subdivide to give our shape more subdivisions. We're going to use loop so that we keep our triangles. Now we can drop down a vellum cloth. And in these cloth settings, I'm going to use set uniform, and I'm going to change the mass to 0.01. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to change the stretch stiffness to 100. And I'm going to change the bend stiffness to 1 lower. Let's drop another vellum constraint, and this is going to be our pin to target. So at the top, we can change this to pin to target. Because I want to pin my whole shape and not a specific group, I can just leave this empty. Let's change this to soft with match animation checked on, and let's change this down to 1. We'll go through these settings in a little bit. Next, we need a vellum solver. We'll jump up to 4 sub-steps, and we're going to remove gravity. Let's dive inside. And let's add a little bit of pop wind. I always find that this gives just a nice organic movement to whatever simulation I'm doing. We can add a value of 2 along the x-axis and 1 in the noise field. We can also add a vellum post-process after our solver. This just allows us to give some more subdivisions. I'll set it to loop mode, and we can also give a slight spatial blur. Let's hit play and see what we get. The soft constraint has a stretch stiffness parameter, which is how permanent versus how much vellum you want your constraint to be. A value of 10e plus 10 is 100% permanent, so it'll match the incoming animation and have no vellum influence. A value of 1 is a mix between your incoming animation and your vellum sim properties. Anything below 1 is now removing the pin constraint and making it more like vellum. You can also set up an attribute pre-vellum to scale the stretch stiffness bar. This is really useful in the pin to target, as you can paint areas that you want to be more pinned and other areas that you want to be more vellum. You can also set the constraints to be stopped. This sets a permanent pin type, but allows you to release these pins inside your solver. This is a very useful constraint type. Let's take a look at setting up the stopped attribute and how we can control this inside our solver. I started with the line and I made it a length of 0.3, and I gave it 5 subdivisions. I then used a sweep, set it to round tube, and I increased the radius. And I added an end cap set to grid. I then subdivided to smooth it out. I added some point normals. I then scattered some points. I then added a line set to the Z direction, 0.12 in length, and I added 8 points. I then used a copy to points to attach each line to the capsuled points. I then used a group expression in point mode set to first point of primitive to set the root group of the first point on each line. I dropped down a vellum hair and I just lowered the bend stiffness slightly. I added a pin to target constraint. I selected my root group and set it to stopped. I then created a vellum solver. I added 4 substeps and removed gravity. In order to release the pins, I wanted a gradient, so they didn't all release at the same time. So I used a MOPS shape falloff to get a 0 to 1 attribute going through my geometry. MOPS is not included in Houdini, but it is a free add-on toolkit. I find it really useful, but you can use any sort of method you'd like to get a 0 to 1 gradient. Let's dive inside the vellum solver and see how I brought in this attribute. I used a pop wrangle and I selected my root group. In the inputs tab, I referenced the null I had created after my MOPS falloff. In the code section, I first bring in my mops attribute with a point function. I then use the mops variable to update the stopped attribute. So now, as mops falloff changes the value from 1 to 0, it unpins the points. So as you can see, pin to target has so many cool uses and functions, depending on how you want to use it. So why don't you check out the provided HIP file, change some of the settings, and let's see what you can come up with. It's Houdini time.